Hello, and thank you for choosing DynaSplint Systems. The following video is designed to help you identify each component of the DynaSplint, demonstrate the fitting process, and provide a general review of the treatment protocol. Please remember that just as each animal is unique, so is each treatment. This video is only a guide and should not replace the assistance of your DynaSplint consultant. Thank you for choosing DynaSplint Systems, where we hope to stretch beyond your expectations.
The equine carpal varus valgus DynaSplint can be used to treat both varus and valgus deformities of the equine carpus.
Your DynaSplint system will arrive fully padded and labeled, ready to apply to the animal. In your box, you will find photographs, written fitting instructions, a treatment schedule that your DynaSplint sales consultant has designed specifically for your animal, additional padding that will be necessary throughout the treatment process, a screwdriver used to adjust the tension throughout the duration of the treatment. You'll also find a FedEx prepaid label. Please save this label as well as a box, as you will need them when you and your consultant have decided that your animal's treatment is complete. Before applying the DynaSplint system, please speak with your sales consultant about adding a wrap underneath a splint. Wrapping is not always necessary, but since each horse is unique, wrapping can sometimes prevent further complications.
Your DynaSplint consultant has labeled the splint according to your animal's condition. If both of your horse's legs are affected by the condition, in some cases, the same splint can be used to treat both the right and left legs. You will see an L for left leg and an R for right leg before each front top, front bottom, back top, and back bottom label. Follow these labels when applying the DynaSplint system to the right and the left leg. For this demonstration, I'll be fitting the splint to the left leg and will be following the left labels only. Hold the DynaSplint system up to the animal's leg to check the length of the proximal and distal struts. The large cam, wrapped with a terry cloth padding, should line up with the middle of the carpus. The distal struts should extend as far down the cannon bone without coming in direct contact with the fetlock. It can lie close as long as the padding and struts are not rubbing or causing irritation. The proximal struts will extend as far up the radius, falling right below the large muscle on the forearm. To adjust the length of the struts, you will find set screws covered with electrical tape or a pull pin and lock adjustment on the proximal and distal struts. First, remove and save the electrical tape. Loosen the set screw by turning to the left. Only a few turns is needed so it doesn't fall out. Slide the tubes within each other to the desired lengths and then tighten. Using the electrical tape, recover the screw. This will ensure the screws do not walk out. What you do to one side, you must do to the other. Some DynaSplint systems have a pull pin and lock adjustment. Simply pull and move the tubes to the desired position until they click in place. To apply the DynaSplint system, open the left front top cuff, left front bottom cuff, and the two counterforce straps. You will notice each wing pad has been padded with blue foam that will protect the leg from various pressure points. This valgus DynaSplint system will have additional padding on the medial wing pads toward the cam, while the varus DynaSplint system will have extra padding on the lateral wing pads toward the cam. This extra padding will aid in keeping the cam away from the knee. If either cam comes in direct contact with the knee, it is very important that you add additional padding to help push the cam away from the knee. Bring the splint around the back of the leg. Line the proximal wing pads up with either side of the radius, while also lining the larger cam covered in the terry cloth padding up with the middle of the knee. Tighten the left front top cuff first, feeding it through the D wire and pulling it as tight as possible. Then, tighten the left back top cuff. This will ensure the splint is tight and will not slide as you go to tighten the bottom of the cuffs. Due to the way the pressure is being applied and the bend in the splint, you will need to maneuver the bottom struts so that the wing pads hug either side of the cannon bone. Once you have accomplished this, loop the left front bottom cuff through the D wire and pull tight. Then, pull the left back bottom cuff snug. Next, go back over each cuff, pulling it snug once more. This will ensure the splint is pulled as tight as possible. Finally, loop each counterforce strap under the opposite strut and pull it snug back on itself. Please note, if you are splinting both the right and left leg, when you flip the splint to the opposite leg, the counterforce straps will not be in the same location as they were on the leg you initially splinted. The important key to these straps is that one is placed in front of the leg while the other is placed behind. One strap should lie above the cam while the other should lie below the cam. Wrap the duct tape around the top and bottom cuffs to prevent the splint from slipping and discourage chewing. To remove the splint, cut the duct tape, making sure not to cut any straps or cuffs. Then, undo the left back top and left back bottom cuffs, as well as both counterforce straps. Once the splint has been removed, be sure to fasten all the Velcro straps in order to maintain proper orientation. Your DynaSplint consultant has preset the initial tension on your horse's splint. If and only if the individualized treatment schedule calls for increasing the tension, it is done in the following manner. Insert the silver screwdriver into the hollow end of the distal strut. To increase the tension, turn the screwdriver to the right. Remember, righty-tighty. And to decrease the tension, turn the screwdriver to the left. Remember, lefty-loosey. Because the DynaSplint system is a bilateral tensioning device, what you do to one side, you must do to the other. The window with the red or blue scales on the distal strut shows the tensioning setting. Be sure they match. The animal will wear the DynaSplint 2 to 3 hours initially. Increase the wear time 1 to 2 hours a day until 6 to 8 hours of wear is achieved. Please follow the treatment schedule your DynaSplint consultant has included in the box. If both legs are being treated at the same time, you can either splint the left leg one day and the right leg the next, or splint one leg in the morning and the other late afternoon or evening. It is very important that you check the leg on a daily basis. This can be done by running your hand up and down the leg, feeling for signs of irritation or swelling. Finally, if there are any signs of soreness or stiffness that persist longer than 20 minutes, please call your DynaSplint consultant.